Now my this discussion is why not to rename it to more neutral name, have more people join in the organizing team or in participate in the organizing the event. Second is how do you want to take up such events forward, not only in Delhi but other parts of country, and what should be the core team doing or what should be the function of such such community coming together. I mean, after all, if you're spending one day, 2 days onto an event, it has to be value to you and to your company and to other people. How to sustain this event? See, this time, as Manik pointed out, that the event has kind of gone down to one or two people or three people even, and it creates really whole burden on organizing to three to four people. And the event, the attendance is less this time because those three people were not doing enough work this time, which was vis-a-vis last time it was more than 170 people who came down to the event. So what, just start sharing your ideas. It's an open discussion on whether you like to have such event. If yes, then what should be the frequency and who can contribute on what kind of things. And also with me, Shishir is there. Shirish, who is also doing the community building activities in open source. They have formed an organization called FOSCA. So probably he will pitch in and say how together we can build such things. So first thing is that you know, you should start raising your concerns about the background of the event. If there are any which are not resolved, so that we together can resolve them.
Okay. So I think first of all, talking about the organizing aspect of it. So what I have found that people are expecting certain people to do the organizing. So that should not be there. But sometimes you may be free or you may not be free. I may be free. I may not be free. So it will be. It should be a kind of rotating process. Okay. The last time these three people are organized. Next time, okay, we need next set of three people. But obviously, most important point is. Yeah, that they have to be the people living in the locality where OSS camp is happening. So for example, if I do an OSS camp in Kashmir, so it will boil down to me or the local people who are living in Kashmir about organizing the venue and other things. So we should not keep on looking at only one set of people that, okay, Vineet did it last time, so we start expecting that Vineet will do it again this time. So everyone has taken initiative or volunteer for something, for organizing these things like looking out for the venue, and looking out for sponsors and other things. So I think first step should be that identifying the local group.
Yeah, but before that, what would be, is why don't we rename the event to FOSS Camp or something like that?
Yeah, obviously that is better. If we rename it as FOSS Camp, that will be better. Then we can leave out versus keep for aside, which was in no way there are previously, but still those people who have the affiliations and other things.
But that's a very genuine affiliation.
Yeah, that is a genuine affiliation. Names are similar. Yeah. Names are similar. There's nothing wrong with them. I don't blame them. They have a certain affiliation. So, but FOSS Camp will be good. If you rename it to FOSS Camp and if you have some other names.
Yeah, I think FOSS Camp.
Do you start volunteering? You'll want to know if I'm volunteering for an event.
Yeah.
I mean, who is doing this event? No. See, yeah, I can't just go and volunteer for anything.
I think we should understand like why this OSS camp was, you know, generated. Like what made it, you know, take part, right? What did happen in bar camp? Like, you know, what we wanted to be here. Because it should not happen like if, you know, if OSS cube is not, you know, doing take it. If OSS cube is not taking any initiative, it should not die, right? So I think we should understand it first. Why it wasn't a part of a bar camp? Even if it is like you want that, you know, if it is a big community, like really technical, you want to concentrate on technical this thing. Why don't we have one smaller group within the bar camp that is mainly, you know, having a smaller group discussions focusing on technical zone, right?
No, absolutely.
So what made it, you know, separate into an OSS camp? Why not having a small group within a bar camp which is only focusing on smaller group meetings? Targeting on only particular technology or particular technical discussions. So maybe we,
yeah,
instead of
I'll tell you two things.
Because it should not happen that,
yeah,
if Vineet is a, I mean, whichever community it is, you know, even if it is bar camp or even if it is like OSS camp, it should happen like the committee is doing it. It should not happen that if Vineet is not taking initiative, that committee should not die.
Right.
So it should be something like if one person is not taking initiative, somebody else is there. Okay. That should, that system should be like.
The problem is finding that somebody.
No, that
leader has to stand up and say, you know what, I'm going to start something. So somebody's going to have to stand up and say, you know what, nobody else is doing it, I'm going to do it. That's done, right? Now, let's forget about the past. Think about what we're going to do from here on. You know, how many people here want to contribute?